Does the recycle bin take up space? And where is the recycle bin? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. When you delete a file using the Windows File Explorer, that file is placed into the recycle bin. The recycle bin has saved many a person from grief, myself included. But where exactly is it? So first off, I'm firing up Windows File Explorer. What we're going to do is use the ellipses, click on Options. On the View tab, we're going to scroll down and click on this Hide Protected Operating System Files. Rather, we're going to uncheck it. And yes, Windows is going to complain. So we will say, am I sure I want to do this? Absolutely, I'm here for a reason. I'll click on OK. And you'll notice now that our view of the root of the C drive has changed. The page file and the swap file are here. But more interestingly, this folder, $recycle.bin, exists. That is the recycle bin on an NTFS formatted hard drive. This other drive I have here, this faux USB, that's an EXFAT drive. You'll find a hidden folder called Recycle Space Bin. Now you'll notice that this is different than $recycle.bin. Recycle Space Bin actually includes the files. You can actually see what's in here. And you can see also what their original location was. Interestingly enough, what you've actually opened is the recycle bin icon on your desktop. I'm going to go ahead and open that, and you'll see that it looks exactly the same. This is the recycle bin. It has all of these things that have been deleted but not yet removed, their original location, when they were deleted, how big they are, etc. How big they are? Yes. They absolutely continue to take up space on your hard drive until you get them permanently deleted from the recycle bin. Now, there are two ways to do that. We can right-click on it and click on the garbage can icon, or delete if that's what you're seeing. A delete within the recycle bin is a permanent delete. So I'll go ahead and click on that. Do I want to permanently delete this folder? Yes, I do. That folder is now gone and it is no longer taking up space. The other thing you can do, of course, is to right-click on the recycle bin and click on Empty Recycle Bin. You can control what Windows imposes as an upper limit on how much space a recycle bin will take up. I'm going to right-click on the recycle bin icon on my desktop again, and this time click on Properties. You'll notice that it is listing the two drives we've been playing with. These are the two drives that Windows currently knows have recycle bins. For each of them, you can see that, okay, space available, it's 126 gigabyte drives, both of them. You can set a custom maximum size. This one, in my case, 8549, was chosen by Windows when I set it up. If you want to make it something different, you can, say, change it to 1. Apply. And now, anything that causes the recycle bin on drive E, because that's the one I've been playing with, to exceed 1 megabyte in size, will cause the oldest files to be deleted. You'll notice, though, that that's for drive E. For drive C, well, it's got a bigger number. It's got the default number. And I'll go ahead and change that to 1024 megabytes. We'll click on Apply. This way, you're controlling how much space the recycle bin can possibly take up. You can jump through some hoops to empty the recycle bin on only one drive. Remember, if we right-click on the recycle bin and say empty the recycle bin, it's going to empty the recycle bin on all the drives that have recycle bins. What if I only want to empty the recycle bin on E? Maybe that's where I'm running out of space. As it turns out, I've got a bit of a hack that's pretty easy and safe. Back in Windows File Explorer, I'm going to go over to my drive E, and you can see I've got a recycle bin. I'm going to delete it. Boom, the recycle bin is gone. Remember, the recycle bin can't be placed in the recycle bin. That doesn't make any sense. So deleting the recycle bin permanently deletes the recycle bin and everything in it. However, as soon as you delete something else that would get moved into the recycle bin will be recreated. What that means, though, is simply by deleting the recycle bin folder, and this works for $recycle.bin on NTFS drives as well, simply by deleting that folder, you've effectively emptied that recycle bin on that drive alone. The recycle bin is something we really don't think about a whole lot, but as I said earlier, it's saved my bacon more than once. And now you have a little bit more understanding of exactly where it is, what space it uses, and how it works. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/173788. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.